Greetings and welcome to episode number 2. In this episode, I will introduce you to 3D Studio Max. We will be looking into how we can personalize 3D Studio Max to get the most out of it. This includes changing our grid and our unit to match our engine. As I mentioned during our previous episode, if you're all new to game development, there might be some new words that will appear during our ride, such as grid, units, unwrap UVW, and others. I will explain these along our journey so that you can fully understand what I'm talking about, so do not worry about them right now. Okay, so let's begin. If this is the first time that you're looking at 3D Studio Max, you might feel a bit scared right now. There is a whole lot of things on the screen, and it might feel a bit repulsing to watch it all. To quickly calm you down is not as hard as it looks. We are probably going to use about 2% of all the available tools in the software, so by all means, do not worry. To make it easier for yourself, the first thing that we want to do is to clean up unnecessary things, such as tools that we won't be using. I've taken the time to remove certain windows and certain tools from my workspace, since I know that I'm rarely going to use them or won't need them. I suggest that you do the same thing in order to get more space to work with. If you for some reason accidentally close something down that you think was important, do not panic because there's always a way to get it back. If you do have a second computer screen, make sure to use it during these episodes. It can become a real hassle just to work with one screen. Okay, now it's time to set up our units. This is going to be very simple to do and it will take you almost no time. Before I explain about units, I have to warn you a tiny little bit. I'm going to be very detailed about this because it's going to be very important to understand. Units are the way you measure your models in. In 3D Studio Max, you can select from a preset of measurements. If you want to model in centimeters, inches, or meters, it's your own choice. You can also model with a measurement called units, which is essentially a neutral measurement system in the 3D world. You can also make up your own type of measurement system for your own game, sort of like creating your own metric or imperial system. On the other hand, that is something that is not really necessary for you to do as a modeler. For most game engines, you want to model in either centimeters or units. Unreal Engine 4 uses centimeters as their measurement system and the Source Engine uses units. In 3D Studio Max, you can either use centimeters or units for Unreal Engine 4, since these measurements are equal to each other. With that I mean that one unit is equal to 1 centimeter. The reason to why you can model in different types of units are because not all game engines are built in the mindset of a modeling software. To give you a good example, if you want to make a character for Unreal Engine 4, the character then has to be 180 units. If you were to make a character for the Source Engine, 180 units would be a colossal character, since the normal height there for a character would be 72 units. The character in the Source Engine would not really be into proportions to the rest of the environment. A normal wall height in Unreal Engine 4 would be around 300 units, whilst the Source Engine uses 128 units. 300 units in the Source Engine would be more like a 3-story building. Luckily for you, there is a scale function in 3D Studio Max, so they can scale your models from small to large or large to small. But it's very important to know what type of measurement system your game engine uses, since that would most likely save you time and trouble from extra work. Alright, to set up your units in 3D Studio Max, you want to simply go up to this top bar up here, where you can see Edit, Tools, Groups and all that. You want to click on Customize, and the third one from the bottom up, called Unit Setup, you want to click on that. In here you can now see Unit Setup. What you simply want to do is set the display unit scale to generic units, and then you want the lighting units to be international. You now want to click on the system unit setup, and as you can see here we have 1 centimeter or 1 unit equals to 1 centimeter. What you can do now is to copy my settings and you'll be good to go for modeling in Unreal Engine 4, Unity, and also the Source Engine. Okay, now that you're an expert of units, let's move on to the grid system. The grid system is something that is very important when it comes to architectural design, and it can be very useful for certain game models. It's mostly used for walls, floor pieces, railings, and things that can be stacked or used multiple times close to each other. I love using the grid since it facilitates my workflow when it comes to placement of models in Unreal Engine 4 later down the line, but you can actually become a successful modeler without using the grid at all. To help us out in the end and to make it easier for us to work together, I thought of actually showing you how to set up your grid the same way as I have it right now. You want to change the grid depending on what you're going to be working with. For example, if you're creating a game such as Minecraft or something like that, you want the grid to be a certain way, and if you want to make something more realistic, such as a forest or things like that, or a house or something like that, you want to actually change the grid to be something totally different. So it's going to be changed depending on what you're working with. Okay, let's go ahead and take a look at the grid now. Up here you can see these sort of snap toggle things, sort of like a magnet icon to them. These are sort of the snap and the grid settings you can change up here. So if I click on one of these, if I right click on one of these, you're going to get a snap and grid settings window. In here you can just copy my settings to make sure that you have the correct settings for actually working and creating something like a box for a Minecraft game, for example. You want to change these depending on what you're going to work with, and you're probably going to figure this out on your own, but for the moment being, just use my settings to make sure that we use the same things as we go along and move forward through these videos. Here's the snaps, the options, the home grid, and the user grids. The last thing that I'm going to cover right now is going to be some optional changes that you can do to the software. Keep in mind these are some optional changes and doesn't affect the workflow as much. If you go into your menu bar and select Views, and then you go down to the drop-down menu and select Viewport Configuration, a window should now open up. In here we're going to change some of the standard settings to make them look better. You can just copy my settings or change them depending on how you want them yourself. The first thing that we want to do is to click on the tab called Visualize Style and Appearance. Here we're going to bump up a couple of settings so that we can get a higher quality on our lights. You can also configure your field of view settings in here. If you feel like you get a bit motion sick when you're working with your models, you can generally bump this field up to remove some of that dizziness. I like to leave mine at 45, which is the standard value, and then increasing it up if I have to. If you feel like I have some trouble identifying your models from time to time, you can generally go into the background tab and change the background colors so that it suits you. If you want to change your layout, you can click on the layout tab to modify that. I have kept the original layout because it works perfectly fine for me. If you click the tab Display Performance, you can change a couple of very important features, such as texture map resolution on your models and anti-aliasing quality. Just copy my settings if you wanted to get some pretty good results when you're working with your models. You can disable a function called Improve Quality Progressively to always have great quality shown on the screen, but it can increase frame drops in the software when you're working with a lot of models at the same time. I tend to have this ticked on by default. Configuration for the regions, statistics, view cube, and the steering wheel have some minor changes that you can play around with. I will show you my settings on here, but I don't feel that there is a need to discuss them. If you are interested in customizing your user interface even more, you can click on the menu bar and then customize. In the drop-down menu, you can select Customize User Interface. In here, you can modify a whole bunch of settings such as colors, fonts, keybindings, and menus, and a lot more. I'm not going to go into too much detail about how you can modify these because these are very simple to do. On the other hand, I will give you a link to my Dropbox so that you can download and install my keybindings. I know that keybindings can be very personal, so the best thing will be for you to personally modify them. I will make a video in the future discussing keybindings and the uses for them. Also, in the next episode, episode 3, I will cover some of the more standard keybindings that are in the software. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, make sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more videos like this. Have a nice day, and I'll see you in the next episode.